when I probably got in junior high, probably, or later in elementary school, because you show up sometimes with them patches on your knees and stuff. You've been out playing all day. You gonna tear up them pants, and you mom throw them patches on them pants. It's fine. They clown your ass all the way to, from, in the middle, on a, clown you all day long, man. For me, man, being light skinned, I was a nigga to the white folks, and I was a white boy to the niggas. So that's another thing that came on a little bit later. Just because my rapist ancestor his genes was a little stronger than yours. That's my fault now. You know what I'm saying? So we caught the blues. Plus, my mom, super pretty, but she looks white. She ain't, but she looks white. And that was a heavy thing growing up, man, because it was hard to deal with some days. Let me put it this way. I got my sprinting skills on back in them days, man, because for me, them dudes was, man, because we grew up in the worst, one of the worst neighborhoods in Pittsburgh, but it was the thug, there were some serious thugs here. A lot of dudes end up going to jail and, killing people and all kinds of crazy stuff later on in their life. And then the dudes want your lunch money. You know what I'm saying? Well, the thing was, my pops was a part of the movement back in the 60s. Yeah, so he was, there's actually a picture of him. Jeez, what magazine is that? I think it's Ebony. And there's a picture of a protest in downtown Pittsburgh. And there's go my pops right in the middle of it. Yep, so I forget which publication it was, but it was like one of around the time Dr. King was doing his thing. Pops had belonged to an organization and all that stuff. So we were, and Pops used to read Black History to us at dinner. Like when he was around, man, he would like, y'all read this, and he had a book and everybody taking a chapter. So we sit down and we read that. So we were very aware of what was going on, especially with the racism that we as a family were catching. Because my, man, you bring my mom to what is it, the parent teacher night? Who doggies? You got trouble, man. Yeah, because they's like, your mom is white. It's like, no, she ain't. She just looked like it. Because once again, the rapist ancestors, strong genes. You figure we were a little microcosm at first, man, because we would like go to a little elementary school and just kind of be there with all your peeps right there in the neighborhood. But then when you start moving around, especially once I start playing music, which was like, I was like 9, 10, 11, man. First time I picked up a bass. So we out playing gigs and stuff, man. So that's when you realize. But I mean, bottom line, man, you knew them cats, they was cool with you. They might rough you up for your little lunch money or something like that, or give you a little grief. But I mean, wasn't like it is today, man, where the mugs will shoot you dead. They might kick your butt or something, but they send you home, Man, the funny thing is, for my pop side, he's got seven siblings. All of them played instruments except him. He was a photographer from day one. He was that dude out there, like, he'd like buy him a cheap camera. Reminds me a lot of you, quiet as it's kept, because you work your craft. I mean, you've taken it to the digital thing and everything. Yeah, but Pops was always grinding that camera thing. So, man, never forget, we used to have this event every summer in Pittsburgh called the Black Arts Festival. So it's basically like a, basically a festival, bands, food, people selling their wares, art, whatever. And I never forget, man, we saw this band, and I don't know who it was to this day. So I get up on this bass player, and dude got his eyes closed the whole time. He's just sitting up there playing, and he's surrounded by women. And he don't see them, he don't know they're there. And I'm like, I want to be that dude. You know what I'm saying? Need to say he gets mobbed after the show, but he was just grooving. And I could tell later in life what he was doing. It wasn't about the chicks. It wasn't about nothing else but being in that groove with that band, because he was in there, he was bringing it. Because he wasn't doing nothing fancy, but he was in that groove for real. And I stood right in front of him behind them chicks, always trying to be around the ladies back in the day. But he was murdering it, and I'm like, I want to do that. So once I got into the music thing, man, it was like I wanted to always emulate what that where that guy went. And I later in life, man, I came up with a name for it, man. It's called getting lifted. Where you because you don't feel gravity, man. Swear to God, you don't feel gravity, man. You don't feel gravity. You don't feel your feet. You don't feel nothing. It's just you, the band, and you look around like when you're playing with some cats and everybody's eyes are closed, you've arrived.
This is